On today's episode, we're going to come back to the drawer frame assemblies. We got a little bit of touch-up to do before we start putting it together. Wait a minute, why is this together?
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by
MicroJig, maker of the Gripper. Work safer, work smarter.
Detailed plans for the 8-drawer tall dresser featured in today's episode are available for sale in the digital download store at mattsbasementworkshop.com.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. So we're going to wrap up the assembly of the drawer frames. Quite honestly, it looks like they're all done right now, but we still have a couple of things we need to do to complete them. The first thing I want to do is to come in here and I want to clean up these joint lines right here. If you remember in the last episode, when we were gluing them up, we used a set of web clamps and we actually put two of the frames in at a time. We put some wax paper in between them to keep them from sticking to one another. Well, those areas where the faces that were up against the wax paper, they tend to have a little bit more glue squeeze out because obviously we couldn't clean them up like we were doing on the other sides. So once they came out, it was time to come back in and clean those glue lines up. And the main reason for that is not so much the appearance of them. It's always nice to have some clean looking joinery, but since these are interior, you're not really going to notice them. It was more important to have those all cleaned up so that the drawers themselves are going to flow right over the top of these nice and easily. Nothing is worse than it kind of sticking on something and you're like, oh yeah, there was some glue squeeze out, so I probably should have cleaned that up. So anyways, we're just going to use our scraper, and then we're going to use a block plane where necessary to, one, take care of the glue, and then two, if for some reason during the glue up something shifted or we just didn't notice that there was a portion proud of the other one, we can just come in and just tweak those little areas so that they're nice and flush. Again, so that our drawers will open and close rather nicely. Real simple, very easy to take care of. Now, the next thing we need to do is once we have all of that taken care of, we're going to come back over here to the table saw, and I already have my stacked dado head cutter set up once again. And for the drawer frames that are for the longer drawers, we're going to end up putting in a drawer guide right down the center here. So that's what we have this set up for, and I'll talk about it in just a second. The main reason why we have that drawer guide is anytime you've ever had a drawer, have you ever had one that you go to open it and it kind of sticks, it shifts on you, and suddenly it's hard to put it in, it's kind of frustrating? That drawer guide is put in there for that specific reason. It's going to help us move it in and out so that it doesn't move a lot. Do you need to have it? No, not at all. But when Brian and I were putting together the plans, he mentioned it, he put it in the plans, and I'm like, you know what, that's a great idea, and we'll go ahead and put that in there. So what we'll do is, again, we'll come over here, I got to talk about the fact that we're going to have a stopped dado and how we'll deal with that. For the top drawers, which are the short drawers, we have four short drawers, of course we have those extra center supports right in there, and that's where we're going to have to end up dadoing the grooves. So we're going to have to come up with a technique to make sure that those are nicely centered on each one. And on top of it, for the first three drawer frames, which include those two short ones, we have to put in a support piece that's going to be a divider for us. So that's where we're going to start. Again, right over here, we need to create a 1/8 inch deep, 3/4 inch wide dado for those top supports that are going to be the dividers for our drawers. So let's get started. So we're over here at the table saw, and like I've mentioned a couple times now, we have the stacked dado head cutter set up, and we have our very first frame here. Now, I should mention, with all of the frames, as you can see in this picture, I went ahead and I marked which is the front rail and then what order each one of those frames are going in. And then I went so far, because I really want to make this as easy as possible as I'm over here, so I don't have to think about the order of where things are going. I can just concentrate on keeping myself safe with the table saw. I marked where I'm going to have the dados at on the piece so I know this is the face and this is where you're going to be cutting. So that's taken care of, stupid. Just concentrate here. For this first one, the very, very top frame, the only dados I'm making are going to be accepting those short drawer dividers, those short drawer supports that we have. There's one in the front and there's one in the back. And I only need to make a dado about 1/8 inch deep. So I'm going to use these Craig setup blocks that I have here. I have a set of brass setup blocks from White Side, and you could easily just do this with a square or something, but what I really like about these is they bridge the whole entire width of the mouth, and then I can get right down here, and I've already got this set up, so it is set to go. So all I need to do now is to actually create the dado. Now, what I'm going to do is This is my strategy. I always go over the strategy first. So that marked face that I have, that's going to be my reference, and I'm going to make sure everything gets referenced off of the same exact side where possible. I'm going to start the dado, plow into it, and then because this one, again, I only need it here and here, once I get far enough into it, I'm just going to kind of lift it up and then readjust it, get my hands out of the way, and then I'm going to drop it down and finish it that way. And we'll end up doing something similar with some of the other ones because we're going to need to do a stop dado, but we'll cover those in a second. So for right now, let's go ahead and plow these. All right, so we've double checked, got our mark, it's going against the fence. I even went so far as to put a mark over here to let me know when it's cleared. So we have our marks, and then let's take our piece, drop it in, and all right, first one done. Now we have three more to go. Now this drawer frame is the second one down from the bottom, and what we need to do is it's going to have a short drawer divider on top and on bottom. So again, we're going to do the same exact thing. We'll reference our mark up against the fence, so that way it will always be the same exact distance, and we'll just cut it like we did before. Set with this one, and then here's our final one. And with all those dados done, here's the dry fit. Now for the next step, we need to raise the blade up to 1/4 inch. So again, we'll use our guides here, and we'll tweak it. There we go. All right. Awesome. So now that we have the stacked dado head raised up to that 1/4 inch height, we're going to go ahead and plow out the dado for the drawer guides here. And this one's just a little bit complicated. Thankfully, we only have a couple of them to do. And of course, these are for the short drawers. We have one drawer guide here, one drawer guide here, and we have it on another drawer frame just like it. What we're going to do is we're going to start here at the front. Now, it's a stopped dado, and it's actually starting 3/4 inch in from the front. So this front face is going to stay solid, but on the back side, we'll see where that drawer guide is. To do this on the stacked dado, I went ahead and I figured out where the back of this blade is, and I marked it here on the fence. And what I'm going to do is line up this leading edge of the frame on that mark, and very carefully drop it down into position, and then once it's in position, we'll just go ahead and plow it through. Now we'll do it both for just this one side, and then we'll readjust the fence so that we can do it for the other side. And then of course, when we get to the longer drawer frames, we'll just have the one to worry about, so we'll set that up. One thing I should mention before I go any further is just to kind of help me lay things out to make sure that I get it exactly where I want in case I ever need to repeat it, I went ahead and I created a story stick, and I should write what these marks are, but I use this to help me get that exact line up for the stacked dado head cutter. So anyways, let's go ahead and get started. All right, so we're getting this in position. We're gonna line up our mark. There it is. That off. Wait for that to come to a stop. There we go. And can we see? We'll just have to clean this little area out right there. So again, using our story stick, we move the fence over, and then now we are all set for that second drawer guide. We could have referenced it from the other end, but I want to keep using just that one face. It's always nice to have one specific reference to work from. And as long as we continue to do it one, and then grab the other, and do those right at the same time with the setup, we're going to get them exactly in the same spot. So let's get started. All right, so we're going to come in, and just like before, we're going to reference that mark over on the table saw fence. Drop this down. All set here. Okay, and I'm kind of pushing towards the fence to make sure that it stays in position and doesn't move. All right, that one's done. Let's do the other one again. Everything lined up. Take a look. All right. You see how we're doing one right after the other with our setup all the same. There we go. Nice and snug. Pushing towards the table, fence. All right. So now we just have four more frames to work on, and these are all right down the center. So once again, we set up our story stick here and transferred it to the table where we're able to move the fence over, get this all set up. We're still going to be referencing that mark there to drop it down and push it forward. But at this point, we're almost done. So we'll double check. There's our mark. We even went so far as to put a mark there to remind us where. Okay. Again, pushing towards the fence. All right, one down, three more to go. And again, we're gonna keep using the same exact setup so we can do this. Check it. Yep. Now I will say, it feels like there's a little kickback as we drop it down, so be cautious if you go this route. Okay, I'm going to finish these up and then we'll come back. So the last thing we need to do is to take care of this stopped dado that we have here, this stopped groove. So I'm going to come in down here, and we had mentioned that we want it 3/4 inch in from this leading edge. So I'm just going to take my pencil and use a couple of adjustable squares here to mark exactly where it's going to be, and then we're just going to chop it out with our chisel. So this time I could probably use my little turned mallet, but I think I'm going to turn to this big guy to make sure that we can get through this in enough time. So let's go ahead and kind of, what I'm doing is referencing the back of that chisel on the wall of this dado, kind of establishing it that way, and then I'm going to go ahead and start chopping away. So this is a 3/4 inch chisel, and this little area down here, if you kind of smudge it up a little bit, it's not that critical, but it's nice to have. So let's go ahead and start chopping some of this away. And this goes surprisingly quick. In fact, what I'm going to do is there's that little ramp in there, and I'm going to step to the side a little bit so I don't hurt myself and start chopping away. I've got it bevel down, because if I was bevel up, once I start pounding, it's really going to dig into the material. So by going bevel down, I've got a little bit more control. Oh, and I see I'm getting a little tearing here on this one, which means that I needed to find that shoulder just a little bit more. There we go. That'll give me a little bit more room. All right, so. You know, the first one, when the camera wasn't on, went a lot faster. Let's go ahead and dig that out. And, you know, that's not too bad. It's a small blemish, but it's not going to have an effect. Okay. So let's square this off. All right. So we're almost there. And then now we're going to clean it up with our router plane. So I've already got this set down here. We'll come in here and there we go. Now I'm sure the B-roll that I'm going to be showing at this point on some of the other frames that we're doing is not going to show that blemish, but you get the idea as we come in here and chop it out and square this up. So I think we are all set, and that's all there is. So I just need to do that on all of these grooves that we did for the drawer guide. Yeah, nice. All right, folks, so this is a pretty good place to stop for today's episode. We had a lot accomplished with the drawer frames here. We cleaned up those joint lines. We went ahead and we put in the dados for the drawer guides, which I really want to emphasize. They are not a necessity when creating any type of chest of drawers or dresser, but in this situation, they're really nice to have, just again, because of the fact that, especially with these longer drawers, that when you go to put them in, you don't have to worry about them wiggling around too much. They're going to go in exactly the way you want them to. But anyway, so we need to make the drawer guides themselves. They're about 3/4 inch wide, 1/2 inch deep, and then the length from the stop dado all the way to the back. What we're going to be doing in the next episode is we're going to be gluing up this whole monstrosity. This is pretty much ready to go right here. So I have some last minute touch-ups here on the face, which I'm just going to hit them with a plane to kind of clean up any burn marks or any milling marks, and we'll get everything in position. And then the whole episode will be devoted to getting this all glued up and ready to go, because I have a feeling that's going to take a lot of time, and hopefully I won't be swearing too much as we go along, because there's a few things that could easily happen, but we'll cover more of that in the next episode. So if you have comments, questions, suggestions, of course you can email me at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com, and you can stop by the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com, where you can leave comments in the show notes, and you can also pick up the digital download of this plan. We have a PDF of it. It's available at mattsbasementworkshop.com/digital-downloads. I'll make sure to have links in the show notes for it, but you can build along with us and have a dresser very much like this yourself and decide if you want to put those drawer guides in. But until the next time, I will be talking to all of you soon. Straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. For more information on topics discussed in this episode, visit mattsbasementworkshop.com. Detailed plans for the 8-drawer tall dresser featured in today's episode are available for sale in the digital download store at mattsbasementworkshop.com. Also, please consider becoming a patron of Matt's Basement Workshop. Get early access to new shows, bonus content from each episode, and so much more. Visit patreon.com/mattsbasementworkshop to sign up and start receiving your benefits today.